Hello students. So students, in the previous class, in this chapter, that is living things and their surrounding, we were talking about that of the breathing. So what is breathing, students? So if we talk about the breathing, so we have seen that the meaning of the breathing is the exchange of the gases. And plants, even animals or human being, they all show the process of a breathing here. Okay, so basically what happened, if you talk about the human being or any of the living organism, so they used to take oxygen and release carbon dioxide. So now basically this oxygen is used by the human being, and the oxygen help in the breakdown of the food. Okay, so this oxygen breaks the food, and from the food itself it obtain energy. So basically we can say that the food we eat to get energy, and this energy is provided through that of the oxygen. And when the oxygen breaks that of the food and releases energy from it, or extract energy from it, that we call as a respiration. Now what happened in case of the respiration, oxygen is taken and glucose is break down, and finally energy is released. Plus, another type of a gas is also released, that is known as the carbon dioxide. So we take oxygen and we release carbon dioxide. This is called as the breathing. Okay, so breathing is what? It is an exchange of the gases. Okay, so one gas has been taken in and another gas is given out, that is known as the breathing. Okay, and the respiration process is what, in which the breakdown of the food occur and release of energy. So in both the process, student, you will find that oxygen is taken and carbon dioxide is released. So basically respiration, what happened, when you take oxygen, this oxygen breaks that of the food and finally energy is released, plus another type of a gas is released, that is known as the carbon dioxide. Now this carbon dioxide will finally comes out through our nose. Okay, so you can see that the process of a respiration, it involves the taking in of the oxygen and releasing out of the carbon dioxide, as it happened in case of the breathing also. So here we had discussed about what happened in case of the human being and the other animals also. Now students, we have seen a lot of a thing, including that the respiration process occur in the animals through skin also. Like if you talk about the earthworm, so earthworm is having a moist skin. Okay, and all the bloods are present, all the blood vessels you can say are present near to that of the skin itself. So when it take oxygen through its skin, so this oxygen directly goes to the blood and finally used up, energy is released and carbon dioxide is released, and finally carbon dioxide comes out through the skin itself. So here we can say that the animals are also there, which is having moist skin, and they used to perform the process of a respiration through skin itself. Now if we talk about the fishes, so fishes, they are living in the water, so somehow they must have a kind of a organ which help in obtaining the oxygen. Now the question is that how fishes will obtain the oxygen? Where is this oxygen present? So this oxygen is present in the water itself. So they used to obtain the oxygen from water, and such kind of a water or such kind of a oxygen is known as dissolved oxygen. Okay, so oxygen is already dissolved in the water, and fish, they used to, the organ which is present in the fish used to obtain the oxygen from water. Now which special kind of a organ is present in case of the fish students, and that is gills. So we already had discussed about it, that it is the gills that when you take oxygen, this gills used to obtain the oxygen from the water itself. So what happened, they through mouth they used to take a lot of water. Which water? The water which consisting of oxygen in it. Now it is that of the gills which obtain the oxygen from this dissolved oxygen, means dissolved water, okay, or from the water itself. So they used to obtain the dissolved oxygen from the water, and finally this oxygen is used up by that of the body of the fish, and carbon dioxide is released in the water again. What happened in case of the human being, we already had discussed. So which special organ is present in that of the human being or in the different animals? So we can say that is lungs. So our respiratory organ is the lungs only, which used to perform the process of breathing and process of respiration. Now we have also seen in case of the plants. So what happened in case of the plants? You know that student, plants used to perform the two type of a process. First one is photosynthesis, and second one which we have seen, and that is known as the respiration. So plants also perform both thing, but there is a difference. That is, in case of the photosynthesis, plant used to take the oxygen and take the carbon dioxide and release oxygen. So here carbon dioxide is taken and oxygen is released. Okay, so carbon dioxide is taken and oxygen is released here. Okay students, I'm writing here carbon dioxide in a full way. So we can write it here, carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide is taken and oxygen is released. So here photosynthesis, it is a process by which plants use to make their food. Okay, so for that they need carbon dioxide. So this is a process in which exchange of gases occur, but carbon dioxide is taken and oxygen is released. Now what is the process of a respiration occur in the plants? So plants also need energy, and so they used to perform the process of respiration in which it used to take oxygen and carbon dioxide is released. Okay, so oxygen is taken and carbon dioxide is released. So this happens in case of that of the plant. Now let us see the another one, students, and that is known as the excretion. So we have seen all the different types, including that of the respiration also, how the plants respire, and this is the characteristic of a living things, that they used to exchange the gases occur. It means they used to breathe, they used to show the process of a respiration. Is the same thing happened with that of the non-living things, student? No, they do not show the exchange of gases, they do not perform the process of a breathing and respiration. Now the next one is excretion. Excretion. What is excretion? Okay. So when we were talking in case of the photosynthesis, students, or even in case of the respiration. So what we have seen in case of a photosynthesis, so the plants, they used to take carbon dioxide and release oxygen. Now in case of a respiration, we have seen that oxygen is taken. This oxygen help in obtaining the energy, and finally carbon dioxide is also formed due to respiration. Now this carbon dioxide is what? It is unused. We do not use it. Okay, none of the living beings except that of the plants which need carbon dioxide only for making food, while other living organisms, they do not need oxygen. Okay, they do not need carbon dioxide, sorry. Okay, so they do not need carbon dioxide. So we can say that, so this carbon dioxide is student is what is not used, or it is unused material. Now it is an unused material, so it should be removed from the body. So we can say that it is a kind of a waste material which should come out, and that is why when we take oxygen, we used to release the carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide is what? It is a kind of a waste material. Likewise, students, when you take food or any of the living organism, they take food, what happened? They used to take food, and the food is used up in releasing the energy, and then what happened? Some of the food is there which left in the body itself, I'm talking. Okay, so that unused food is what? It is a kind of a waste material. So here, when we will not going to say unused, but the remaining one is what? It is a waste material. So such kind of a waste material should be removed from the body, and the process of the removal of the waste material from the body, from the living body, is what is excretion. Okay, so we can write about excretion. So the first point that we can write here, student, that the living beings obtain, or living beings use food to obtain energy, use food to obtain energy. And by which process? By the process of respiration. Okay, so through the process of the respiration, energy is obtained. Okay, now this process will make the carbon dioxide to left out, which is a kind of a waste material. So the process of respiration produces carbon dioxide. It produces carbon dioxide gas as a waste material. Okay, so through this process, carbon dioxide is released, and this carbon dioxide is just, you can say, is a waste material, it's a useless only. Okay. Now, this is in the first case of students, in which we are saying that when we take oxygen, a thing is produced inside our body, a gas is produced, and that is known as carbon dioxide. Now, if we talk about the food, so we can say that a part of the food in the living organism remains unused. Remains unused. And the unused part is called as waste material. Okay, is called as the waste material. So you see, students, the things which I want to convey to you people, that we have seen the two situations that occur with all living organism. We used to take oxygen and unused material is formed, unused gas is formed, which is called as a carbon dioxide. Now when you eat food, what happens? It goes to our stomach and through our intestine. So during this process, what happened? Few part of, or you can say a part of, means after taking out all the nutrient from the food also remain unused. So this is talking about that food. It means a part of the food in the living organism which we used to take, it remain unused. It means all the nutrient is used up now, so it becomes unused here. Okay. Now this unused part is also called as the waste material. So we can say that either carbon dioxide or this unused part of the food material, both are the waste material. And what happen if suppose these waste material will remain present in the body? It becomes poisonous. Okay, so we can write it, that this unused part, if remains in the body becomes poisonous. So what is important, that it should be removed from the body. Okay, so it is necessary to remove it from the body. Okay, so we can say that basically this happens in our body, and we will say that the waste material which is present in the body, it should be removed. Okay, and by this only we will get the definition of the excretion, and that is the removal of this unused part or the removal of the waste material from the body itself is called as excretion. Okay, so we can write it, the definition also. That is the removal of the this unused part or waste material from the body is called excretion. Okay, so what is excretion? It is what? It is the removal of the waste material, that is called as the excretion. Now let us move on, students, and we will see that what are the different kind of a waste material is formed by that of the living organism, including the animals as well as that of the plants also. So you see, students, the living organism, they used to form urea or a kind of a salt also. So carbon dioxide also. So these are the some of the waste material which is formed by that of the living organism, and it get rid of by the body either through the process of the respiration. So through the process of respiration, carbon dioxide is removed. Now if a urea is there or other kind of a salt is there, so this will comes out from the body through that of the urine. Okay, so by discharging urine, actually we are discharging these waste material. Now not only this, the solid waste material, it means the unused food which is formed in the our intestine, it will comes out through the body. Means we can say these are the solid waste which comes out through the body by the in the form of a feces. Okay, so we can write it that what are the different kind of a waste material which is present in our body. Okay, so let us write it. All the living organisms, get rid of these waste material by themselves. Materials by themselves. So what are the different kind of a waste material, students, which is formed in the body? So these are the important waste substances are the important waste substances, the important waste substances which are produced in the body, of an animal are urea, carbon dioxide is also there. Okay, then feces are there. Okay, so these are a kind of the waste material which is formed in all the animals. Okay, so we can say that it is very important to get rid of these kind of the waste material, otherwise it will become poisonous and it will going to harm the body of the living organism itself. And these waste material, how it get removed? So the living organism, they used to get rid of such kind of a waste material by themselves only. How, students? Look, let us see. The animals, if we talk about the carbon dioxide, they used to release the carbon dioxide through the nose itself in the air. So you know that we used to take oxygen and release carbon dioxide. So release of the carbon dioxide is also occur through the same process, but we used to remove the carbon dioxide outside, or used to remove the carbon dioxide to the एयर। So we can write it, that is the oxygen, the animals gives out carbon dioxide through breathing. In air. Okay, so they used to release carbon dioxide through the process of the breathing itself. Now, the animals remove the urea, salt material. Some of the salt material or salt substances is also there in the form of urine. Okay, and finally, the third one is that is. The animals gives out the solid waste. From the body. In the. Form of faces. Okay, so you can say that likewise excretion occur in case of the animals. Here we were talking about in case of the animal students that basically the animals used to produce some kind of salt or a kind of urea and even that of the solid waste also. So and carbon dioxide, so all this should be get out. And how? So you know that when we breathe out, the carbon dioxide comes out from the nose itself. It means it comes out in the air through the process of the respiration, through the process of the breathing, you can say. Now the urea is there and some of the other salts are there, so this should be removed, and it is removed in the form of a urine from the body. So we can say that urine, when we discharge urine, the salt and some of the urea also releases through it. Now this solid waste, it also get released in the form of feces. So you can say, students, that such kind of excretion occur in case of the animals. Now if we talk what happen in case of the plants, so is plants also perform such kind of a thing? They also remove. So you have seen that the plants, they do not do such kind of a thing. They do not use to discharge urine or remove their solid waste like this method as the human being and the other animals used to do. So how the plants used to perform? So first of all, we should know that what are the waste materials which is there in case of our plants. So basically, if we talk about the gases, students, so the plants, they are having two type of gases. And in somehow we can say that the waste material are both, and both can be used. Like during the daytime, students, you will find that the rate of photosynthesis is high, as we have discussed in the previous topic also when we were talking about the process of a respiration. So they used to take the carbon dioxide and releases oxygen. So during daytime or during performing the process of photosynthesis, the oxygen is a kind of a waste material which is removed by the plant. But at that time, the carbon dioxide is the useful one. So the first one is like that. What happened in respiration? So during night time, you see that the process of respiration is high. So they used to take oxygen and carbon dioxide is released. Now this carbon dioxide is what it now become a waste material. So plants, the both of the gases can be removed, but depends during daytime or during night time. Okay.